we're told to find the following integrals, and we're given the graph of f right over here. So this first one is the definite integral from negative 6 to negative 2 of f of x dx. Pause this video and see if you can figure this one out from this graph. All right, we're going from x equals negative 6 to x equals negative 2. And the definite integral is going to be the area below our graph and above the x-axis. So it's going to be this area right over here. And how do we figure that out? Well, this is a semicircle. And we know how to find the area of a circle if we know its radius. And this circle has radius 2, has a radius of 2. No matter what direction we go in from the center, it has a radius of 2. And so the area of a circle is pi r squared. So it'd be pi times our radius, which is 2 squared. But this is a semicircle, so I'm going to divide by 2. It's only half the area of the full circle. So this is going to be 4 pi over 2, which is equal to 2 pi. All right, let's do another one. So here we have the definite integral from negative 2 to 1 of f of x dx. Pause the video and see if you can figure that out. All right, let's do it together. So we're going from negative 2 to 1. And so we have to be a little bit careful here. So the definite integral, you could view it as the area below the function and above the x-axis. But here, the function is below the x-axis. And so what we can do is, we can figure out this area, just knowing what we know about geometry. And then we have to realize that this is going to be a negative value for the definite integral, because our function is below the x-axis. So what's the area here? Well, there's a couple of ways to think about it. We could split it up into a few shapes. So you could just view it as a trapezoid, or you could just split it up into a rectangle and two triangles. So if you split it up like this, this triangle right over here has an area of 1 times 2 times 1 half. So this has an area of 1. This rectangle right over here has an area of 2 times 1. So it has an area of 2. And then this triangle right over here is the same area as the first one. It's going to have a base of 1, a height of 2. So it's 1 times 2 times 1 half. Remember, the area of a triangle is 1 half base times height, so it's 1. So if you add up those areas, 1 plus 2 plus 1 is 4. And so you might be tempted to say, oh, is this going to be equal to 4? But remember, our function is below the x-axis here. And so this is going to be a negative 4. All right, let's do another one. So now we're going to go from 1 to 4 of f of x dx. So pause the video and see if you can figure that out. So we're going to go from here to here. And so it's going to be this area right over there. So how do we figure that out? Well, just the formula for the area of a triangle, base times height times 1 half. So, or you could say 1 half times our base, which is a length of, see, we have a base of 3 right over here. We'll go from 1 to 4. So 1 half times 3 times our height, which is 1, 2, 3, 4 times 4. Well, this is just going to get us 6. All right, last but not least, if we are going from 4 to 6 of f of x dx, so that's going to be this area right over here. But we have to be careful. Our function is below the x-axis. So we'll figure out this area, and then it's going to be negative. So this is a half of a circle of radius 1. And so the area of a circle is pi times r squared. So it's pi times 1 squared. That would be the area if we went all the way around like that. But this is only half of the circle, so divided by 2. And since this area is above the function and below the x-axis, it's going to be negative. So this is going to be equal to negative pi over 2. And we are done.